Files and Folders. In this video, I want to give you a briefly introduction, how to work with files and folders in UiPath. We need that later in the examples, once we want to write a link query to work on files or folders. Let's first understand, what does a file mean? A file is a single unit of information that is stored on a computer. It can contain text, images, audio, video, or other types of data. An example for files is an Excel file, Word, PNG, text, PDF, XML, etc. In UiPath, we have many different activities to work with files. For example, the following activities, which we can use to create, copy, rename, move or delete a file. Or also an activity to loop files inside a folder. I will talk about these activities in a moment. Let's first check what does a folder mean. A folder is a container used to store and organize files. It means, we store the files inside a folder. We also have different activities in UiPath to work with folders. For example, copy, create, rename, move, delete or loop folder. So, UiPath offers a range of activities for working with files and folders, but these activities cannot be used within a link query. If you want to use these functions within a link query, you will need to utilize vb.net code within an assign or invoke code activity. In this video, we will demonstrate how to use certain activities as code within a link query. Everything will be in vb.net language, because this course is only in vb.net language. Before I start explaining the different functions, please make sure you have the following namespace in your workflow, so that you can use the different functions in your workflow. You have to add it under imports in the workflow, where you want to use the functions. Now I will show you the most important functions, what I will use later in the queries. Let's start with the first one, get files from a directory. As the name suggests, this function is to get the files from a specific folder. There are four different overloads for this function. I will discuss only three overloads of them, what I will use later in the next videos. These are the three overloads, what I will discuss in this video. Let's first understand what does each one mean, then I will show you practical examples in UiPath, how to use them in UiPath. The first one is to get all files from the directory. Here we have only one input parameter of type string. For this parameter we have to set the folder path, from which we want to get the files, like this one here. The second one has two parameters. The first one is also the folder path. The second one is search pattern to specify, which files I want to get from the directory. For example, this one to get only the Excel files from the folder. Or this one to get the Word files from the folder. Or also this one to get only the files, which have the number 2 in the name. So, the search pattern parameter consists of two parts with a point between them. The first part is for the name of the file. The second part is for the extension of the file. Once you set asterisk instead of the name, it means that you want to get any file, no matter what is the name. The same also for the extension. If you set asterisk instead of the extension, it means you want to get any file from the folder, no matter which extension it has. The third overload has three parameters. The first two parameters are the same like the second overload. The third parameter is for the search option. Here we have two options, either all directories or top directory only. The difference between both is, if we want to get the files from the folder only, or if we want to get also the files from the subfolders inside the folder. So, the first option returns all files from the folder and subfolders. And the second option returns only the files from the folder directly. That's all about these three overloads. Let's switch to UiPath to see how to use this function. I have the following sequence, where I created two variables. The first one is of type string. It's for the folder path. I added the folder path as default value, from which I want to get the files. The second variable is of type string array, to store the files we get from the folder. I use the function more than once. Each time I use different overload or different values for the parameters. The first one is to get all files from the folder. It's the first overload. The second one is to get only the Excel files, which have XLS extension. The next one is to get only the Excel files, which have XLSX extension. The next one is to get all files from the directory, but only from the top directory. It means, we get only the files from the folder directly, but not from the subfolders. The last one is to get all files from the directory and all subdirectories inside this directory. After each assign activity, I am printing the content of the string array so that you can see which output I will get from each code. Each item inside the array will be printed in a new line. Let's see the folder and the files before I execute the code. As you see, here is the folder what I want to search. It contains 10 different files and 3 folders. Each folder contains also some files. Let's now execute the code to check the result. The execution is finished. Let's check the output. We first have the output from the first code, where I used the first overload. I got all files from the folder only, but not from the subfolders. The next one is the output of this code. It's the second overload, where I want to get only the Excel files with extension XLS. Here I also got only the files from the folder, not from the subfolders. The next one is for this code. It's also the second overload and to get the Excel files, but only with extension XLSX. The next one is the output of the third overload. Here I got again all files only from the folder, not from the subfolders, because I use search option with top directory only. And the last one contains all files from the folder and all subfolders inside the folder, because I use search option with all directories. This is how to get files from a folder. The output here was of type string array. The array contains always the file paths of all found files. So, we get only the file path for each file, with no further information. But sometimes we need to get more information about the found files, like the size, extension, name, creation time, etc. To get this information, we need to get the files, not as string array but as file info array. Let's first understand what does file info mean and contain. Then I will show you how to do that in UiPath. FileInfo is a class in the .NET framework system.io namespace that provides methods for working with file information. Here is a list of the most important properties that you can access using a FileInfo object. Creation time gets or sets the creation date and time of the current file or directory. Directory gets the parent directory of the file. Directory name gets the full path of the directory that contains the file. Exists gets a value indicating whether the file exists. Extension gets the string representing the file extension. Full name gets the full path of the file. Is read only gets or sets a value that determines whether the current file is read only. Last access time gets or sets the time the current file or directory was last accessed. Last write time gets or sets the time when the current file or directory was last written to. Length gets the size of the current file in bytes. Name gets the name of the file without the path. In addition to these properties, the FileInfo class also provides various methods for working with files, such as copy to, delete, move to, and open. These are the properties and methods which we can use once we have FileInfo object. Let's now see how to get the files from a folder as FileInfo array. First, we define a new directory info with the folder path in brackets. For directory info, there are many different methods, such as create, delete, move to, etc. One of the methods is also getFiles. This method is what we need to get the files from the folder. So, I will use the method here, which has 4 overloads. I will talk about 3 overloads, which I will use in this course. The first one is without any parameters. It means, I just have to use the method with empty brackets. In this way, I will get all files from the folder, and only from the top directory. The next one with search pattern to define which files I want to get from the folder. Here we can use the following pattern, for example, to get only the Excel files. The last overload is using search pattern and search option. Here we have again these two options, either top directory only or all directories. Using one of these statements, we can get the files from a folder as file info array. After that, I can use this array to get more information about the files, like the name, size, last write time, etc. Let's switch to UiPath to see how to do that. I have the following workflow. I created a new variable of type FileInfoArray. It's to store the output of the code. I use the variable here. And here is the statement to get the files from the folder. I use the variable folder path, which has the following value. After that I use the first overload of the method getFiles. It means, I should get all files from the folder only, not from the subfolders. After that I use the activity for each, to print out the information of the array. For this activity I use the type argument FileInfo, because the array is of type FileInfo. Inside for each I have a write line activity to print out some properties of the files inside the array. For example the name of the file. For that I am using the variable file, which is defined in the for each activity. After that I have other properties, such as extension, full name, directory, and many other properties. Let's execute the code to check the result. As you see, I got all files from the folder. For each file I got the different data, like the name, extension, full name, directory, directory name, and so on. All these lines are for only one file. Here is the next file in the folder. These are all files inside the folder. Let's now try to use another overload, for example the third one. For that I will use the following pattern, to get only the Excel files. And I want to get all files from the folder and all subfolders. Let's execute the code again. As you see, I got all Excel files from the folder and subfolders. For each file I got all information I want. Here is a file from the subfolder. And another one. And also one here. This is how to get files from a folder as FileInfo array. This is very important for us later, once we want to write a link query for files. So, keep it in mind how to do and what is the output. Using these statements we can for example write a link query to get the oldest file from a directory, get the sum of all files, get the newest file, or doing many different calculations. Another method I want to show you is, GetDirectories. This method can be also used for directory info, to get the subfolders from a folder. For this method we have again different overloads with the same input parameters like getFiles method. The first one is empty, to get all subfolders from the folder only. The second one is with search pattern, to get specific folders. The third one is with search pattern and search option, to define if you want to get the subfolders only from the top directory, or also from the subfolders. Let's now see, how to read a text file using VB.NET code. As mentioned, we can do that using the activity read text file. But I want to do that using a code, so that we can use this method inside a link query. So, let's see how to do that. We can do that in two ways, either we read the text file as string, or a string array. It depends on our need, what we want to do. Let's see the methods for both ways. I will start with the first one, read text file as string. For that I can use the method, read all text. This method is under namespace, system.io.file. We can use this method as following. I just write file then the method. In brackets I will set the path of the file I want to read, like this one. The output of this method is of type string. The other method is to read the file line by line. The output here will be of type string array. It means, each item in the array represents a line from the file. Here we also use the namespace, system.io.file. To use the method I will also write file, then the method with the file path, like this one. These two methods are helpful for us, once we want to write a link query for a text file, to get specific data from the file, or to check something inside the file, or to manipulate the file, or many other things. If you want to learn more about these methods, or any other methods for files and folders, I recommend you to check the namespace system.io on Microsoft documentation. There you can find all methods you need to work with files and folders. That's everything I want to show you in this video, what we will use later in this course.